So, hello, welcome here to a new video, and today we're going to talk about everything that we are in, and we're going to start off with Bankroll Flow, and yeah, with Bankroll Flow, actually the price went up again, so that's already not too bad. And if you're new, by the way, make sure to subscribe, leave a like, comment down below what you think about the videos, and maybe suggestions of your side. But yeah, we are here in Swap, better to say Flow, and we are here gonna do a roll. Because, you know, we like to roll, and with rolling, everything goes into the deposit, because at the moment, they're gonna change the APY, so the best thing to do is keep on rolling, because if you keep on rolling, you're gonna don't care about the APY, because the APY will be so or so way too high, and with that being said, we switch accounts, because you need to think about compounding changes the APY to completely, and with compounding you basically make more money in general, because your deposit will grow faster and faster, and because of that you're basically gonna get more returns in the end. As you can see, my USD value always goes up a bit. Of course, it's not going up dramatically, because yeah, I only have a small amount into Bankroll, but still, that small amount goes a long way, as I would say. So with that being said, that's it already for the Tron blockchain. At the moment, there's not too much we could look at. We maybe could look at Nui and stuff like that. But to be fair, there's not a lot going on the Tron blockchain. Everything moved over to the smart chain on Binance. Yeah, let's see if I even got some stakes. Yeah, well, 40 UX and 4.7. So yeah, all in all, you know. Like, TRX is basically dead a bit. I don't know. Maybe TTRX says something different. Because they always get dividends, as it seems like. So, let's look at it. And we might... Yeah, still 26k. In the pool. At 115 and 1 TRX so far. Not too bad at all, but you know. We're no longer heavily invested into them. So... let's actually change the smart chain. And we're gonna explore a bit what happened on the smart chain. And we need our pancake swap for that as well. So, for BSCX, what happened? Am I still staking? No. I pulled my liquidity a few hours ago. Just to make sure to not lose anything, because we were in huge profit. And that huge profit... I already sold some on SwapX, and yeah, I sold a lot of BCX for BUSD. I got 1,281, and if I would sell those, that would give me 358. So we have 1,600 BUSD approximately in our balance. So is that bad? No, it isn't, because we already sold some, and everything's been far. The fees are really amazing. That's why I used to be as the Binance Smart Chain, you know. That's the reason why we are on here, because the Ethereum fees at the moment are way too high. For Pancake, at the moment, the price 270. So also, not too bad at all, to be honest. So if we look at some pools, we're gonna see that the APY is going up a bit, and actually it's not too bad to have a look at what pool you want to join, because there are some with great returns, and you can get more to the APY, because you simply can compound, and when you compound you get even more tokens, you know. That's the best thing about everything. So you have Lina here, you have EGET, and the only thing you need to do is basically stake cake. And how you get cake is if you go over to the exchange, connect your wallet, select the currency, go in, press cake, and then you take, for an example, your BUSD, 100, and because I'm not connected, now you still see the price. So we will get 36 cake for 100 BUSD, and those would be then staked onto something else. They got NFTs going on, so yeah. there's a lot which is going on, to be fair. Yeah, I don't know how the NFTs trade in Cake or keep it for your collection. So I don't know if you still can buy those. I think the most have already sold. So we just have a chance to win, okay. So that's actually the full NFTs. Ah, okay, sadly, okay. Would be nice to get some NFTs because they look actually not too bad. Let me say that. And yeah, NFTs are basically big. And oh, okay, you have a team and profile. So you have referrals on Pancake, so good to know. Because this far, I didn't set up a profile this far. So choose your starter, costs 4k. Ah, okay. So. One sec. Okay, so yeah, basically what you need, 4k, which you go buy. Then you can choose your profile pick. Choosing your profile pick is an NFT, as I found out. And when you do that, you basically can join the team, set the name, and do everything. The total cost, 5k. So, it's not too expensive, as I would say. Of course, I don't know if I'm going to do it, because this far, I'm not using it. But still, I would consider actually doing it, because it's not too bad. Our pools, what happened? We unstaked Acro and Ethereum. We actually still got the Acro in the balance. If we change to the Ethereum mainnet, we basically see, of course, the prices are wrong. Then we need to change, go back. So, the Acro, where is it? It is white. Here. We still have 818 bucks in Acro, 16,000, and we basically sold some for Ethereum, some for DAI, and with removing the liquidity, we also got some more. Wow, we got 314 USD worth of BAU. And that's from one staking from one pool, and we know we got some more in the other pool. So all in all, we have about 600 USD worth of BAU farmed. And that is also not too bad, if I would call it that way. So the liquidity we still provided is the SUSD Ethereum one, which is worth 2k. The Ethereum that we got went a bit down because, yeah, Ethereum went up in price. And if we were told that Ethereum amount, of course, we would do more profit, but still, making it in the pool, we actually earned a lot of profit. Because, you know why? Because we will get a lot of BAU that is locked at the moment, but when it's unlocked, it will be worth even more. So, we got 7 million all in all of BAU, basically. So that means, if we go over CoinGecko, search for BAU and put in 7 million. You see that we got 14,000 USD farmed from BAU this far, which means it's actually not too bad at all. We earned a lot of money this far, and we will earn even more because we simply let it sit there, collect even more rewards, and maybe we're gonna look at new pools that come out here and there, gonna invest back into them and make even more profit with them because they offer a real good amount of pools where you could farm with a lot of tokens. And you know, that is one thing that I actually enjoy, because diversification, very important in the current space, because you don't wanna go all in into one project, because that's just simply stupid. There you see, basically the APY also went a bit down on the Acro one, but still, if you want to farm it 1000%, that's still a decent amount, as I would say. I'm not even like, would say, I would be careful. No, it's simply still stupid. League good the returns that you get. Even 1k, 2k, still great. And the best thing about it is you get it paid in the future. So at the moment you get a smaller return, but in the future your return will be even huger. And that's the thing which gives me thinking, like, always looking at different pools which are worth it and everything, because it's just so insane. It's insane, you know. This is what you can do with stablecoins. Of course, I don't know how many are in those pools. I need to look at the calculator. Actually, there's a calculator out there of BAO, and then you can basically calculate a bit the returns. So that's it. Enjoy the video. Subscribe. Until tomorrow.